All right, welcome back to Close Up, everyone. Finally this morning, the third major U.S. Senate candidate in the race is former State Senator Jim Rubins. Good to see you, sir.
Good morning.
How do you feel your campaign is going 9 days out now from the primary?
Oh, it's going really well. I'm here. I'm working. I've lived in the state 40 years, started 10 small businesses. I've worked with my hands and my back, and I've helped startup companies, high-tech startups, get going. And I'd like to lift up this great country. I'd like to improve people's lives, and I'd like to do the same thing I did in the state Senate, which is to bring bold ideas to the table that solve problems. We've got some serious problems in the United States of America. We can fix them, but it's going to take someone with some passion and someone who is thoughtful, someone who is principled, and we can do all of this consistent with our core Republican values of individual liberty, constitutionally limited government, free markets, balanced budgets.
It all sounds good, but what issue? Right. I mean, you got to win to do all that. So, what issue? What platform? What do you think will make the difference for Jim Rubins come primary night?
Number one on this is jobs and a candidate who is willing to serve the people of New Hampshire, who's not captured and owned and operated by special interests, who's made no deals with large money entities that distort the political process and prevent us from solving the big problems of the country. I mean, we've got a debt problem. We've got a tax code that is forcing jobs off. Sure, and we can fix this stuff. We know how to do it. It's doable if we have candidates like myself who are not owned and operated and made deals with special interests that don't want to fix these things.
Let's talk about one of the issues of the day, and there's a difference of opinion in the first two candidates when it comes to ISIS. Your thoughts on how the U.S. should approach this?
Yeah, I'm very leery. We do not need to go to war in the Middle East. The dogs of war are pounding the drums for a third Iraq war. Okay, we've got ISIS. They're barbaric. They are against all principles that we hold dear in the United States of America. We can deal with them in a different way than this. I propose, instead of going to war and committing our troops there, because this bombing war that's being proposed, the Pentagon has warned folks, this will require, if we really want to hold land and suppress ISIS permanently, will require at least 75,000 American boots on the ground. And we don't need to do that. What we do need to do is have better on-the-ground intelligence. As recently as a year ago, when Gene Jaheen voted to bomb Syria and strengthen al-Assad, we were supporting and training and arming ISIS. This is a year ago, and now we're bombing them. So to the rest of the world, it looks like we're completely haphazard. We don't seem to have any plan over there. Instead, what we need is far better on-the-ground intelligence, and if it's disclosed there are individuals or groups that have plans or plots that would harm Americans, we can use surgical techniques to take them out.
Sure,
and
I'm interested in what you mean by that when you say on-the-ground intelligence, because obviously you're not talking about boots on the ground, so, I mean, you're talking about special forces. I mean, how do you think we're
talking about developing over a period of time. It takes time to have a network of relationships so that the United States knows what's happening, and it's going to require the engagement of foreign countries in the region that are our allies, that have the same interest that we do in regional stability. We need to make sure. Much better use of coordination.
But quickly, though, and then I'll move on. There are a lot of people that think that we don't have the time to establish that there's an immediate threat that needs to be dealt with now before it arrives on our border.
Let's walk through bombing. Let's say we bomb ISIS. These people are cockroaches. This is a new form of enemy, and we will bomb them, and they will hide their arms. They will retreat into cities and in population areas and disappear. And yes, we can suppress them, but as soon as we leave, as soon as the bombing stops, they will pop back out again. These warring tribes have hated each other for over 1,000 years, and we're not going to change them. We're not going to make them into American-style citizens. They will pop back out and begin their war again. So we need to have a method to protect America. Permanent deals with threats that actually exist. We do not need to defend those boundaries that were created in 1916 by France and Britain. They have no relationship to these warring tribes. We don't need to hold ground, and I have seen for too many years, and it sickens me to the heart, that our young men and women are coming back in boxes and without legs and with brain injuries for no improvement in U.S. national security.
All right. Let's talk, get back to the race, because we have just a couple of minutes to go. There are those, and I'm going to be frank with you, there are those who have taken a look at the poll numbers and say, not only can he win the primary, he can't beat Gene Shaheen, talking about Jim Rubins, and to a certain degree, Bob Smith.
Well, let's start with Gene Shaheen. Gene Shaheen is weaker than she's ever been in her political career. She is joined at the hip with President Obama. who is not guiding the nation in the correct direction. And if you want a candidate, there is another candidate in this party who votes with Obama, but I don't think that's the right approach. What the polls are showing, and this is another thing they're showing, huge, over half of voters in the state here are still undecided on this election. This is going to be an extremely late-breaking election.
In the case, do you suppose that is?
The anointed candidate is not selling. I picked that up very clearly in the field. And people are doubting. They have seen politicians come to them with proposals. I'm going to do this and that for you. And these politicians get to Washington. I'm not like that. I'm not going to be a career politician who seems to be fixated on nothing but getting reelected and forgetting about the people. I have sworn not to become a lobbyist after I leave office. I'm going to give my pension back to the taxpayers. I've term limited myself. So I'm a different kind of person. I'm down there like a volunteer fireman to lift this country up, to improve people's lives, and not to be owned and operated by special interests. And this is a difference. And I'm making that case to the people of the state of New Hampshire, and this is what the people want.
You say that you're referring to Scott Brown when you say he's not selling. Well, polls seem to indicate he's selling better.
Well, that's name ID. It's purely, at this point, it's name ID. I have lower name ID, but as you can see, I've got, you know, three super PACs advertising for me now. We got our own ads up. My name ID has rocketed. I know that in the last month or so since my advertising campaign went up. And again, what are people looking for? They're not looking for someone with high name ID. They're looking for someone who will solve the country's problems and turn this around. I've got the bold ideas. I'm a principled person. I'm free to say the truth as it is. And like I say, I've brought ideas to the table to solve this country's problems.
Sure, quickly, what do you say to a voter that says, well, you know, we have two other former U.S. senators in this race, and I'm more prone to go to somebody who's got the experience, well, more versed in the ways of Washington?
Yeah, I had no experience when I hit the state Senate, none whatsoever. In fact, the leader of the Senate told me, Jim, you've got to spend 2 years getting your legs under you and get your feet on the ground, get a committee chairmanship. I persuaded that individual to give me a committee chairmanship day one, and I went right to work. I got SB 2 voting, all-day voting passed into law. Five times the number of people are now voting in town and school elections. I went right to work on electricity competition, which got passed into law. We've saved millions of dollars in the state for ratepayers. I wrote and passed the charter school law. We have 22 of them in the state right now, and kids' lives are being turned around. Kids all over the state have schools that are tuned to their needs. They're reaching their full potential, and taxpayers are saving money. So I went right to work in the state Senate. I get to do exactly the same thing in the U.S. Senate. Go right to work on solving the people's problems.
All right. Well, best of luck to you moving forward in this race. Time is flying. Good to see you. Thank you, Senator.